Today, I want to add some gaming accents to this enclosure by installing RGB lighting. As you can see, I also need some ventilation, so I'll be attempting to add that also. To see how I do this, stay tuned. Up until now, I've used the enclosure with the cover off to help with cooling, and that's worked fine. Still, after putting the cover back on when I'm done, the look of a GPU enclosure with a clear cover is really nice, so it's time to make the clear cover a more permanent fixture that doesn't need to be removed to provide cooling. The first thing to do is make the air intake openings in the cover, which I'll cut into the bottom rim of the clear cover using my soldering iron. There will be 16 holes spread out around the perimeter of the rim. That should allow a reasonable amount of air intake to help displace the hot air generated by the GPU and the power supply. Here's a look at the air intake holes after some cleanup I did to remove excess melted plastic. Next, I'll be cutting a hole in the top center of the clear cover where the fan will be mounted. I picked up this 120mm fan from Amazon. The price was a little high, but the diameter was a little bigger than some of the cheaper ones I looked at, and the reviews seemed to justify getting this one over the others. I'm going to mark the center of where the fan vent will be cut by marking the intersection of lines extended from opposite corners of the clear cover. Using a dense sheet of cardboard that I got from a three-ring binder I was discarding, I made this template to help guide the soldering iron when I cut out the fan vent. The circle cutout in the cardboard is 116mm, just under the overall size of the fan, which is 120mm. The cardboard is durable enough that it won't burn away before the clear cover melts. As long as I keep moving and don't stop in any one spot for too long, I should end up with a nice circular cutout. Cleaning up the cutout is easy since the hole is so large. I'll clean off most of the rough edges, but not worry too much about it since it'll be covered by the fan. To mount the fan, I felt screws might be too risky, thinking the weak plastic with the hole near the edge could eventually crack. Instead, I'm using goop glue, like I always do, to hold the fan in place. I decided to install a minimal amount of RGB around the GPU fan and power supply. For the GPU fan, I'm mounting these vertical fins so the RGB will face outwards around the perimeter of the fan. The fins are cut from a couple of cottage cheese containers. The containers are conical in shape, which makes it easy to find a portion of the container where its circumference fits the GPU fan just right. I cut out about a 3/4 inch wide strip from the same section on both containers and glued them in place using goop. The USB port on the Beast has a maximum capacity of 500 milliamps. That's barely enough to power both the fan and the RGB, so I'll have to see what happens once everything is installed. The USB port's mediocre capacity was another reason I kept the lighting to a minimum. I'm putting this strip of 3/4 inch heat shrink tubing over the start of the RGB strip because it'll be needed about halfway through this process. I'm going to mount the RGB around the GPU fan first because it's closest to the USB power source. The sticky backing on the RGB strip makes it easy to mount it temporarily as you go. When I'm done mounting the RGB strip, I'll glue them down more permanently using small amounts of goop. The only thing that concerns me with these fins are that the plastic is so thin, I'm afraid they may melt or sag. It'll be one more thing to test once everything is installed. I'm using this black heat shrink to cover the RGB strip where it transitions from the GPU fan to the power supply. This hides the strip of lighting between the pieces and makes it appear to be individual light strips on each part. The power supply will have RGB on part of the sides and over the top. I'll also be gluing these RGB strips in place afterwards. Cutting the end off, according to the instructions, must be done at a joint where there are copper pads. Finally, I'll put a dab of goop about every inch on either side of the strip for its entire length. You can either buy a USB splitter or DIY your own. Because I always do things on a budget whenever possible, I DIY'd this one. In doing so, I could get the exact cable lengths I needed for each connector. Connecting to the mounted RGB strip is this piece that handles remote control of the light colors and flashing patterns. The other end of that piece then connects to the USB port for power. Wiring to USB is very simple, which is why I focused on finding USB powered accessories. The only drawback for this build was the limited 500 milliamp coming from the port. For the fan's cord, I bundled it up to get the right length and to put the speed control near the fan. I'll let the cord hang down the corner where it connects to the splitter. This is my modified and improved external GPU enclosure. Though I only have a single fan, the cooling ability works really well, allowing me to now leave the cover on throughout gameplay. The RGB is also a nice touch. I feel more lighting might have had a better impact, but I'm still satisfied with the minimal RGB accents to the enclosure. If this three-part series motivates you to build your own external GPU enclosure, good luck, and if you make a video of it, leave a comment where I can find your enclosure. I'd like to see other DIYers' ideas. Leave your questions and comments in the comment section below. That's all I have for now, and I'll catch you in the next video.